In Jesus' mighty name, glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. I welcome you to our live Sunday service, glory to God, on Zoom, and we'll be on Facebook in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Our God is a good God, so we welcome all the viewers that will be on Facebook. We also welcome all those that always participate with us on Zoom. Glory to God. Our God is great. Welcome to a new month. The glorious things are spoken of thee, O city of God. Hallelujah. This is a glorious time to be alive on earth. Glory to God. It might not appear so, but it is. You know, when gross darkness covers the earth and darkness the people, his light, the light of God, will arise in us. His glory will be seen through us. Hallelujah. So these are greatest days to be alive. But these are days, again, that we as God's children, we ought to seek the truth, to know the truth, to walk in the truth, to live in the truth, to manifest the truth, you know, to demonstrate the truth. We are children of the truth. The glory to God. James 1:18 says, he gave birth to us by the word of his truth. We are God's children. We are born to be blessed. We are called to operate and walk in the blessing. Glory to God. We are the children of Abraham. We are blessed. Whether the devil likes it or not, we are blessed. Glory to God. We are blessed with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Glory to Jesus. So we walk in victory. We walk in dominion. This is our confession. Glory to God. These are the things that we ought to speak all the time, despite what you see. See, Job writes, when men are cast down, thou shalt say there is a lifting up. Hallelujah. We are speaking a lifting up in the month of November. We are declaring a lifting up in the month of November. Yes, as the COVID-19 viruses, the cases are increasing in hospital. And in England, there is going to be another global lockdown from Thursday. We, as God's children, we continue to declare that we are not of this world. Glory to God. Though we see pestilence around us, we refuse to be influenced or affected by it. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are children of glory. We belong to God. Take note. We are children of glory. Oh, hallelujah. Where you are right now, just declare, I'm a child of glory. See, I am a child of glory. You see, when we are saying we are the children of glory, we are not saying this thing to make us feel good. This is the truth. We are declaring the truth. Your worst critic, it is never going to be people around you. It's not your spouse. Your worst critic is not your in-laws. No, it's not the people that you work with. Your worst critic is you. Hallelujah. So we need to learn to overcome that self, that voice that speaks to us that we are worthless, that we can never accomplish what God has called us to accomplish. You will accomplish great things in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever God has called you to do, evangelist, donor, whatever he has called you to do, you will accomplish it. With God, I love him. You know, at the age of 100, that's when Abraham had Isaac. God is not a God that looks at the time. God is a God that looks at a heart that is willing. At the age of 80, Moses started his ministry. At the age of 80, Caleb says, as I was 40 years ago, so am I today. Give me my mountain. There are mountains to claim. There are mountains to possess. Yes, Sister Mother, there are mountains to claim. There are mountains to possess. We ought to rise up and lay hold of that which belongs to us. God has called us not to be a weak church, but he has called us to be a powerful church. He said in Matthew 16, unto this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. take note. It was not an apostle who said it. It was not a prophet who said it. It was not an evangelist who said it. It was not a pastor, neither a teacher who said it. It was Jesus. It was Jesus. So he said, unto this rock, I will build my church. We as God's children gathered all over the world in Facebook land, gathered all over the world in Zimbabwe, in South Africa. You know, we are the church of the living God. It is time for us to rise up with the spirit of boldness. So in this month of November, refuse to settle for religion. Refuse to settle for less. Settle for who God says you are. Glory to God. You see, the Bible says in the book of Psalms, glorious things are spoken of thee, O city of God. We are the city of God. Glorious things are spoken of us. What do you think Jesus is saying concerning us? The ones that he purchased with his blood. What do you think he is saying? Is he saying you are useless? Is he saying you are worthless? No, he is saying, before I formed thee, I knew thee. I ordained thee. God called us. God chose us. Before the foundation of this world, he chose us to walk in victory. He chose us to live in him, to abide in him. After all, John 15 says, I am the vine and you are the branches. Take note now. Take note. The life of the branch is in the vine. Glory to God. So the life that we have, it flows from our relationship with Jesus Christ. So if Jesus is God's beloved son, well-pleasing to the Father, if we are connected to the vine, who are we? We are well-pleasing to our Father. Glory to God. All we have to do is to pray for the spirit of revelation, that our eyes will be enlightened to the glorious things that God says concerning us. You see, God says glorious things concerning us, and religion comes in and messes it up. God says you are blessed with all spiritual blessing in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. It's all because of Jesus. It's got nothing to do with what we have done. It has everything to do with that man from Galilee. It has everything to do with God's only begotten son, that word that became flesh, that word that was willing to be crucified on the cross, that word that was willing to die on the cross. When he died on the cross, before he gave up his breath, he said, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, my God, why have you forsaken me? God was able to forsake Jesus Christ because our sins, our filthiness were put on Jesus Christ. So who are you? If God forsook his only begotten son because of our sins, so that when Jesus has dealt with the power of sin on the cross, on the third day be raised, incorruptible by death, incorruptible by hell, we were raised with him. We are seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus with him. We abide in him. We live in him. God chose us in Christ before the foundation of this world to be holy and to be blameless. He chose us in his love. That was the work of grace. It was not the work of what we are doing. Yes, I thank God for the opportunity to minister. I thank God for the opportunity to give to the things of the kingdom of God. But it was not my giving. It was not my ministry. It was all because of Jesus. Oh, this month of November, let the name of Jesus be glorified. Let the name of Jesus be lifted up. Wherever we go, let's lift up the name of Jesus. Let's glorify that name, because it was Jesus who was willing to lay aside his divinity, to carry that cross, to go to Calvary, to pay the price. He paid the price, the highest price. He became obedient to death, even death on a cross. That is Jesus. And God gave him a name that is above every other name, that at the mention of Jesus, every knee shall bow down, every tongue shall confess. I don't know what knee you are dealing with right now, but what I know is there is a God in heaven. It might be the knee of the coronavirus. You might be operating in anxiety. You might be operating in fear. You might be looking at circumstances in your life that you have prayed for. Things have not changed, but I am here to tell you, the that there is a name that is above every other name. That name is the name of Jesus. God gave him a name. He said at the mention of Jesus, every knee should bow down. So the knee of coronavirus, it has to bow down in our families. He promised us that he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High God, he that abides under the shadow of the Almighty, Jesus is the secret place of the Most High God. We abide in him. We live in him. We shall say, the Lord is our strength. The Lord is our rock. He is our fortress. He is our banner. We shall not be moved. Yes, though 1,000 shall fall on our side and 10,000 on our right hand, it shall not move us. It is not moving us because of Jesus. It is not moving us because of what our Heavenly Father has done. How great the love of the Father that he demonstrated on the cross. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. It was not because we were righteous. It was not because we were good. It was because of his goodness. Today we are claiming territories. We are claiming grounds against the work of the enemy in your family, in your marriage. You have to say, enough is enough. I have a name that is above every other name. That is the name of Jesus. Today I want to lift up the name of Jesus. I want to glorify the name of Jesus. We are not glorifying the name of a church. We are not glorifying the name of a minister. We are not glorifying the name of a pastor. It is not the name of a pastor that will save you. It is not the name of a ministry that will save you. It is the name of Jesus. The name Jesus means God is Savior, the Savior of the world. He came 2,000 years ago. He put a mark on this earth. He put a mark on this beloved world. He said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him. Today, as we are gathered, wherever we are gathered as believers. We are not unbelievers because we believe in the only begotten of the Father. Whosoever believes in him should not perish. So we refuse to perish this wonderful, wonderful, wonderful afternoon. We are declaring that we are operating in victory. We are operating in power. Come what may come. We will not walk in fear. We will not walk in anxiety. We will not be intimidated because we know who we are. We know whom we have believed. We are strengthened in this, that he that began a good work in us, he will carry it unto completion until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. If God started something, God is able to finish it. God is able to see it through. So we are not leaning in our own strength. We are not leaning in our own ability. We are leaning in the ability of the supernatural spirit, the Holy Spirit, the one that has been promised. He lives on the inside of us. He dwells on the inside of us. If the spirit of him that raised Christ from the dead, if he dwells on the inside of us, he that raised Christ from the dead is able to quicken our mortal bodies. So we are declaring we are quickened by power in this month of November. We are quickened by the power of the Holy Spirit. We are saying, Father, we thank you for that rock that you are building your church on, that rock which is Jesus Christ. So as we come before your throne of grace this wonderful afternoon, we are saying, you alone are God. You are God of every situation. He is God over every situation. Glory to God. The enemy kept the children of Israel in bondage for a long, long time. You know, and then God sent Moses, says, it is time to deliver them. It is time for us to operate in victory, to operate in power. It is time, glory to God. When we see gross darkness on earth, when we see darkness on earth, it means God is preparing his church. He's preparing his children. He's about to do something great, something so supernatural. It won't have anything to do with us. It will have everything to do with who he is, what he has said. All we have to do is to circle around those promises, to walk around the promises. Just as the children of Israel walked around the walls of Jericho, they were intimidating, but God says, you walk around them. Walk around what God has said. Walk around his promises. Walk around what he has said concerning his church. Walk around what he has said concerning you. He has said, I chose you. Before you were formed in your mother's belly, I knew you. I called you. I ordained you to do what you ought to be doing. In the mighty name of Jesus, it is not time to be seeking after opinions. It is not time to be seeking after other voices. God is saying in the month of November, I'm shutting down every voice. I'm lifting up and raising up my voice. My voice will become prominent in you. It is time to switch off every other voice and to switch on God. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I'm turning on your voice. Whatsoever you say, I will do. Just as in John chapter 2, there was no wine in the wedding of Cana, and Jesus said, whatsoever, the mother of Jesus says, whatsoever he tells you to do, do it. Whatsoever Jesus is telling you to do in this critical hour, in this critical time, you do it. Glory to God. Whatsoever he tells you to do, do it. Because as you do it, you will see the manifestation of his glory. You will see the manifestation of his power. His strength will be seen through you, because he works through his word. He works through his word. In the beginning, God created heavens and earth. The earth was void. It was formless. God did not circle around and start wondering what he was going to do. He said, let there be light. And there was light. Now watch this. 1 Peter 1:23 says, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible seed. We are born of the word. It's time to allow that word on the inside of us to arise. Glory to God. It is an incorruptible seed. It's not a corruptible seed. You are not the flesh. Glory to God. You are not your thinking. You are who God says you are. His word says you are born of the word. You are born of incorruptible seed. What's born of flesh is flesh. What's born of the spirit is spirit. I'm born of the spirit. I'm a man of the spirit. These are the things that we ought to be declaring. I'm born of that word. As you begin to declare that, the word on the inside of you will begin to arise. Ye are of God, little children. You have overcome them, says John in 1 John 4:4. For greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. The word of God is on the inside of you. It is in your spirit. You meditate on it. You begin to speak it forth. You begin to declare it forth. You do not focus on lying vanities. You focus on what God has said. When you focus on what God has said, you will begin to manifest what God is seeing in the heaven. God has called us to see the way he sees. He has called us to speak the way he speaks. He has called us to declare the way he declares. Why? Because we are the church of the living God. And to this rock I will build my church. We are built on Christ, the living stone. Glory to God. Thou art Christ, the living, the Son of the living God. I'm built on the rock. The rock that is Christ is unshakable. It is unmovable. So are we as the church of the living God. We are being built by God. Paul, as he's about to finish his ministry, in Acts chapter 20, verse 32, he says, I commend you to God and the word of his grace. It is the word of his grace that is able to build you up. It is the word of his grace that is able to give you an inheritance. It is not somebody pouring oil on you. It is not a prophet somewhere else, but it is the word of God. When you come to the revelation of the word, when you allow that word to dwell inside of you, Jesus said, abide in me and my word abide in you. And then you shall ask of anything, it shall be done for you. Because when that word is on the inside of you, the word of God has power. It has power to bring change. It has power to bring transformation. It has power to bring a resolution that can move mountains. It has power to bring illumination where there is darkness. That is the word. The word became flesh. We beheld the glory of the begotten of the Father. That is the word that God spoke to a virgin called Mary, and Mary was able to get pregnant. I sense in my spirit right now that as we are about to enter into 2021, there are people that are pregnant. They cannot wait to give birth to greatness that is on the inside. I just came as a forerunner to declare that right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, everything that is on the inside of you, it will come forth. It will come forth. Whatever that spirit of delay is, right now, in the mighty name of Jesus, I come against every structure of the enemy, every stronghold of the enemy, right now where you are. This is a time to praise God. This is a time to declare that devil, enough is enough. It is time for that word to come to pass. It is time for all the promises of God that have been spoken over my life to come to pass, because we know in 2 Corinthians 1:20, his promises are yea and amen find in Christ Jesus. It is all to do with Jesus Christ. It is all to do with what Christ has done. We are the children of the Most High God. We walk in power. We walk in dominion. We shall dominate. We shall dominate. We will not be losers. We will not be defeated because we know who we are. We have been raised with Him. We are seated with Him in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. We are people of power. We are people of authority. So we will not submit to whatever the enemy is saying. We will not submit to corrupt governments. We will not submit to the things of the enemy. We will not submit to deception because we sense right now that there is a revelation of truth. We will walk in truth. We will walk in everything that God has called us to be because it has nothing to do with us. It has everything to do with the Holy Ghost. Father, we thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit. Right now where we are, Father God, we thank you that the anointing of the Holy Spirit is working mightily to do only what you can do. All that we are going to do, Father, is to believe who we are in you. Lord, we love you. In Jesus' mighty name, glory to God. God is a good God. Welcome to the month of November. Hallelujah. There is greatness in each and every one of us. Hallelujah. We are a royal priesthood. We have been chosen. You see, God handpicked us, selected us to live in this generation for such a time as this. It's time to be bold, to declare what you are called to do. Hallelujah. Let's turn our Bibles to the book of Ephesians. God is awesome. He's worthy to be praised. Don't be moved by what you see. Hallelujah. Jesus was not moved by the cross. We are surrounded by such a great cloud of witness. He said, let us lay aside every sin and every weight that easily entangles. He said, the sin and the weight, it is the things that are around us. And he tells us how, focus on Jesus. Focus on Jesus. Don't focus on what you are seeing around you. It's a mirage. Glory to God. It's a lie. We are not moved by what is around us. We are moved by what God has said. By what God said. He says, focusing on Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him. You know, there was a joy that was set before him. What was that joy? You know, what was that joy? What was the joy that was set before Jesus? What was the joy? That was you and me. Glory to God. Jesus saw what was on the other side of the cross. Yeah. So, and he saw that that was his joy. For the joy that was set before him, we were dead in our sins and our trespasses. But the joy that Jesus saw, he endured the cross. Glory to God. Scorning is shame. You know, he could not be moved by what he saw. Yeah. He laid it aside, said there is Pastor Lom on the other side. He's going to be a mighty man of valor. He's going to be my servant. That one I've called him. I've called him to do great things in the kingdom of God. So I have to go through this. As I go through this, he will one day come and start preaching this message. That was the joy of Jesus Christ. He saw me. Hallelujah. And he had to endure the cross. Let's lay aside every sin. He said, we as God's children, let's come out of focusing on us. You know, that triune us, me, myself, and I, to come out and say, Lord Jesus, this is a critical hour, critical time that we are living in. But I thank you that as you have said in Isaiah 60, arise and shine, for your light has come. The glory of the Lord has risen upon thee. Lord, I'm rising up higher and higher like an edifice. This is a time to begin to speak in tongues like never before. This is a time to begin to praise him like never before. This is a time to step out of religion, step into Jesus Christ, to step into him, to know him. This is a time to download from heaven because the spirit of revelation is flowing freely, unhindered by any demonic forces. This is a time to say, just like the apostles did, they forsook all to follow him. This is a time to say, Jesus, I'm forsaking my own ideology. I'm following you. I'm living this. I am following you. I'm coming out of me. I am following you because my desire it is to know you. My desire is to walk in you, to live in you, to manifest that which you have called me to manifest. For I am called of you. I'm anointed of you. Your spirit is at work in my life. I am in you. You are in me. Together, Jesus, we are invisible. We are unstoppable. But by myself, I will continue working. By myself, I will continue me to strive, but you have called me to thrive. You have called me to be victorious. This is not the time to focus on the mountains. This is not the time to focus on what has not yet happened. This is the time to focus on him. This is not the time to focus on, I prayed for this, but it did not manifest. This is the time to say, Lord, I give you glory. I give you praise for who you are. Whatsoever I have believed, whether I have not seen it or I have seen it, my desire is to manifest you in this generation. My desire is to walk in you in this generation. My desire is that the power of the Holy Ghost be seen through me in this generation. Because these are greatest times on earth. Those that are tuned into the heavenly atmosphere, they will operate with the glory and the atmosphere of heaven. Wherever they go, glory to God. These are days when God is looking for people that his heart is towards him. His heart, their hearts are fixed towards him. Their hearts are submitted and yielded to his Holy Spirit. These are not times to be doing church the way we used to do church. These are times to be the church of the living God. Wherever we are, wherever we are placed, these are times to say, Lord, I thank you. You say you are building your church. I am that church. In this job, I am that church. In this business, I am that church. In this community, I am that church. Move in the way that only you can move. I can only submit to you, say, in Jesus' mighty name. Will we have a priest today? Hopefully we will. Glory to God. Where did I say we should go? Ephesians chapter 2, verse. We don't have time. Ephesians 2, verse 6. Glory to God. God is awesome. He's worthy all the glory. He's worthy all the praise. Let's find out. Hallelujah. We ended the year. Verse 6, verse 5. Even when we were dead, I want us to take note, right? Even when we were dead in offenses, made us alive together with Christ. It says we were dead. God made us alive together with Christ. See, this is the revelation of Christ and the revelation of the church. See, it says we were dead. Anything that was dead, it did not exist before. Glory to God. See, it did not exist before. You never existed before, right? We started existing when we said yes to Jesus Christ. Listen to what it says. Even when we were dead in offenses, made us alive together with Christ, right? I want you to stop there. I want to take you back, right, to Ephesians 1, right, from verse 19, because this is a connection. There was no glory to God. This is a connection. There was no chapters, verses, glory to God, right? Listen to what verse 19 says. Ephesians 1, 19. Now, he is praying for them. Let's start from 18. The eyes of your heart, having been enlightened, glory to God. This is revelation knowledge. See, if the eyes of the heart is not enlightened, what you will have is a religion over revelation knowledge, right? See, Christianity is divine enlightenment. It's a revelation. Until it becomes a revelation, what people will have is a religion, right? So that is why Paul is praying here for the church in Ephesus. He said that their eyes be enlightened. These are the prayers that I've prayed over myself. He said, my eyes are enlightened. Glory to God. They are enlightened. When you begin to pray these prayers, when you go back to reading scripture, all of a sudden, revelation knowledge begins to flow free because you have prayed, you have believed. And these are the most important things to pray for as God's children. Glory to God. We have to pray these prayers. You know, of the spirit of wisdom, of the spirit of revelation, of enlightenment. You see, it's to take off the cover on what is there. Now, he is saying here that the eyes of your heart, remember, what the enemy does is to blind our hearts from seeing. You remember the account of the prophet Elisha. He was surrounded by the Syrian army. As he was surrounded by the Syrian army, he was not moved. But his servant was moved, right? He saw with the natural eyes the army of Syria. Because he saw with the natural eyes the army of Syria, he started panicking. You know, when our eyes are enlightened, whatever we are going through, whether it is in our marriages, in our finances, with our children, in our workplaces, when your eyes are enlightened, you will not be moved. You will see it as an opportunity of God to manifest his glory and to manifest his power. Elisha continued having his full English breakfast. He was not moved. And then he prayed for the servant. He says, Lord, open his eyes. Glory to God. This is what Paul is praying. Hallelujah. Open his eyes so that he can see. You know, when our eyes are blind, we don't see. This is the prayer. Every time when I was growing up, when my grandmother came here in 2001, this is the prayer he used to pray. She used to pray for me. Father, that the eyes of his heart be enlightened. I didn't know what it was. Glory to God. I was always asking myself what it was. That is why when you see, when I begin to teach this thing, revelation knowledge, it flows freely and unhindered. You know, why? Because of that prayer that was prayed. God is honoring that prayer. So revelation has to flow freely. You then have divine enlightenment. Because the word of God, it can only be revealed. Hallelujah. It is the Holy Spirit that takes the cover. Jesus said, the words that I speak to you, they are spirit and life. The flesh profits nothing. Glory to God. You can read the word of God from a place of intellectualism. It will not benefit you. You need divine enlightenment. You need to be enlightened. That's why so many people would get into this Bible that ought to set them free, but it leads them into captivity. It leads them into bondage because the eyes of their heart has not been enlightened. The same scripture, the same Bible that can set you free to do great things, it's the same Bible that has kept many in bondages. And that is why Open Door Christ Center exists. That is why we are here. Glory to God. We are here to speak revelation knowledge. Hallelujah. We are here to declare the mysteries of heaven. This year alone, as I was, you know, praying, seeking God, the Lord started speaking to me. He says, Lom, you are a revelatory preacher. I was like, I'm a what? So, you are a revelatory preacher. I was asking, Lord, what does that mean? He says, you speak from a place of revelation. You know, when you begin to declare, you are taking off the cover from scripture. You are making scripture come into reality. Glory to God. You see, it is revelation that we seek. The words that I speak to you, these words are spirit. They are life. Glory to God. But the same words have kept people in bondage. Hallelujah. You see, 2 Corinthians 3:17 says, the Lord is the spirit. Where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Right? Liberty, which is freedom, emancipation from bondage. It says the Lord is the spirit. Where the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. The spirit of the Lord is on the inside of us as God's children. So if we are not operating according to divine enlightenment, we will operate in bondage without realizing what is on the inside of us. Because like Elisha's servant, we will be focused on the Syrian army. You'll be focused on the sickness. You'll be focused on the disease. You'll be focused, I've been praying for this. I've not seen the manifestation of it. And then the enemy will be feeding you lies. He will be telling you lies. Then your prayers will be based from what the enemy is saying. It's no longer based on revelation knowledge. There are many that pray from a place of what the devil has been saying, not from a place of revelation knowledge. Glory to God. So when somebody tries to bring you to a place of revelation knowledge, you are already fighting. What you are fighting is you are fighting God. You are fighting your purpose. You are fighting your work. Glory to God. You are fighting what God has called you to do, what God has called you to manifest. So when you are praying from a place where the enemy has been feeding you lies through scripture, the same devil that tempted Jesus, it tempted him through the word of God. If Jesus did not operate according to revelation, he could have jumped. Many Christians, they jump because the devil has said, jump, God will take you, right? God wants us to have a revelation, divine enlightenment. Hallelujah. That is why Paul is praying this. The eyes of your heart having been enlightened, listen to what he said, that you might know what is the hope of his calling. The hope of his calling. There is a calling upon your life. There is a calling upon my life, and I'm operating in it. Glory to God. It's not guesswork. It's not second guessing. No, it is divine enlightenment. See, you have to know what you are called to be as a child of God. The moment you make a decision for Jesus Christ, the number one prayer point that you should pray for is not a marriage prayer. It's not a financial prayer. No, it is your calling. Glory to what you have been called to do. Because when you start operating in what you have been called to do, you will discover that everything will fall into alignment. So then when you come into Jesus Christ, into the revelation of who he is, into the revelation of who Jesus Christ is, he begins a work inside of you to lead you into your calling. The quicker you cooperate with him, the quicker you get to your destination. Glory to God. Some cooperate with him 2 years before they die. Some cooperate with him quickly enough, right? So that is why Paul is praying this prayer, that they might know the hope of their calling, but from a place of revelation. From a place of revelation. Because without revelation, you could not know what a church is. Then you will be operating in deception, right? Remember our topic for today, yeah? Deception versus, you know, what did I talk about, right? What did I say? What was the title? The revelation of Jesus. Deception of doing versus the revelation of being. Glory to God. The deception of doing versus the revelation of being. What you see right now, many are operating from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. Think of it. We are always presented with a choice. I've set before you life and death, blessing and curses. God said to the Israelites in Deuteronomy 30:19, choose life so that you and your descendants shall live. Glory to God. So these are the choices that we have in life. And the enemy understands this thing. So what he does, he stops revelation flowing to us, understanding the things of God from a place of revelation, right? So these choices, they come from the Garden of Eden. Remember, in that garden, the most important trees, there was the tree of life, the tree of knowledge of good and evil. As God's children, we are in the place called life. I will build my church. The gates of hell shall not prevail against it. I'm getting ahead of myself. You know, this is not what I want. But you know, I'm getting there. See, I will build my church. We were dead in our trespasses, right? God raised us with Christ Jesus. We already have eternal life. We possess eternal life. We are in this place called life. We have eternal life already. We have life. That tree of life that was in the garden, glory to God, that is Jesus crucified on the cross. The cross is a symbol of a tree. It's a symbol of life. We enter into Christianity through the cross. There is no other way. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. The way is the cross. Glory to God. We can only find the way through that cross, because when Jesus died on the cross, he dealt with the sin. Sin brought death. But watch how the enemy operates, like the deception of works. The tree of knowledge of good. The good. See, most Christians will never commit adultery. Most Christians will, I hope, they will never steal. They will never do crazy things. But they will do good things that are not flowing from life. Right? That is the deception, right, of doing. A rich young ruler came to Jesus. You know, he came running. Good teacher, what can I do to have eternal life? What can I do? He was a doer. And Jesus asked him, why do you call me good? Only God is good. Now, the rich young ruler, you know, he was confused. Most of us, because of lack of revelation, we will then get confused with the rich young ruler. Because we'll say, I thought Jesus was God. No, revelation, right? Jesus, when he answered that rich young ruler, he wanted to find out if he was operating in enlightenment. Revelation, do you see me as God? Do you see me as the one that can give you eternal life? Do you really see me as who I am? Who do you say I am? Yeah, only God is good. So when you are saying, why do you call me good? Am I God? Do you see me as good? The Bible says Jesus loved him. When he loved him, what's this? Do you know the commandments? Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal. You know, he named the 6 commandments. Now, the rich young ruler, to be rich and young, not commit adultery, that's a tough ask. Poor, broke young people are committing adultery. This one was rich. Take note, he was a Jew. He followed the law. He did. He was doing. He tied. As a Jewish man, he died. He honored his parents. He did everything, but he did not have eternal life. Glory to God. He was doing. That is the deception from the tree of knowledge of God. On the natural, the community, when they saw that young man, he was a good man. If you were the pastor of a mega church or a church and you see him, he's tithing, he's doing everything, he's honoring his parents, he is prospering, and then there is a position opened there for an associate pastor or a deacon or something, you could have chosen him, right? Because of he was good on the outside. That is the deception that many of God's children have fallen under. The doing from the tree of knowledge of good is the good that they do. You attend the church, you do good things. Hallelujah. It's not coming from life. Hallelujah. So you need enlightenment. And Jesus said, go sell everything you have and give it to the poor. Then come follow me. You shall have treasure in heaven. You shall have treasure in heaven. He went away sad because he had lots of good stuff. Glory to God. He could not give it away. See, eternal life is not, we don't get it by doing. It is a gift. Hallelujah. The wages of sin is dead, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. Glory to God. That is the gift that God has given us. That is what Jesus was saying. But the rich young ruler was doing. Cross over again to the story of Mary and the story of Martha. Martha opened the door. Jesus came in. Martha started doing. Right? Mary said, glory to God. So as Mary said, Martha became so distressed and distraught. Says, Lord, carest thou that I'm doing this? Mary is sitting down. Martha, Martha, thou art troubled by many things. Mary chose what was right, and it shall not be taken away from you. You see, revelation knowledge comes when we sit under Christ. When you sit under him, when you follow him, you cannot follow him and not produce good works. Oh, getting ahead. I'm trying to get to Ephesians 2:10. Glory to God. You see, as Mary said, when you sit under the word that I speak to you, they are life, they are spirit. In John chapter 6, Jesus fed 5,000 people, multiplied bread. You are doing works, right? The works that I do, so shall you do. Glory to greater works than this, shall you do. So he multiplied bread for people that had no intention of following him. In John 6:28, they come. They follow him. Like they go to the other side where he was. They ask him a question. What shall we do to do the works of God? That was their question. What shall we do to do the works of God? Listen to what Jesus said. One of my favorite scriptures in the book of John. The works of God is this. Believe in him that he has sent. Believe in him that he has sent. He said, we do because we are in eternal life, glory to God. We do good works because we are in Christ. We live in him. We move in him. We are not doing to try and get God to endorse us. We are not doing like Martha to say, Lord, carest thou what I'm doing? You see, I have tithed. I have given to every person that has asked of me. I have jumped when the preacher says jump. I have screamed when they've asked me to scream. Where is the breakthrough? Where is the harvest? It's because you have. From the tree of knowledge of good, you have, not from believing. All things are possible to him that believe. Glory to God. That's why we need enlightenment. It's deception. This is what the enemy is using to deceive us, to get us into good works, to get us into doing. Then when you do, you're not seeing the manifestation. Then what happens? You get stressed and depressed as a Christian. There is no joy anymore in serving the Lord. Glory to God. You are no longer coming from a place of rest now. You are coming from a place of, you are tired. What was Jesus' invitation to the Jews? Come to me, all you who are weary and heavy laden. I will give you rest. Glory to God. That was an invitation. See, in Christ Jesus, the revelation of Jesus Christ, it is a place of rest. We are doing because we are in this place of rest. Glory to God. We walk with him. We are workers together with him. Glory to God. So it's no longer me that is doing. It is the Holy Spirit working through me. The Jews, in John chapter 5, Jesus had healed somebody who was paralytic for 38 years. So they come to him because it was a Sabbath day. They are complaining because it was a Sabbath day. How can you heal on a Sabbath day? Jesus said something powerful. What I do, I see my Father do. The works that I do, I see my Father do. That is who we are as God's children. See, we are in Christ Jesus. You know, we live in him. What we do should be because we see Jesus. We have fellowship with Jesus. We are in a relationship with Jesus. We are not trying to do to get heaven to move. We are doing because we are in him. We live in him. We abide in him. What did he say in John 15? I am the vine, you are the branches. So if we are the branch is connected to the vine. The life of the branch is in the vine. So in the vine, there is no sickness. In the vine, there is no disease. In the vine, there is love. In the vine, there is joy. In the vine, there is peace. You see, that is why we have to change our mindset, to come out of religion, glory to God, to realize that we are in him. If I remain in him, listen to verse 2 of John 15. It says, my father is the husbandman. The branch that does not produce fruit, he prunes it. You know, the branch in me that does not produce fruit, he prunes it so that it can bear much fruit. That is Jesus Christ. You see, we do because we are in eternal life. We are in him. Glory to God. He is divine. We are the branches. That is Christianity on road. Glory to God. True Christianity. It's no longer religious Christianity. It is us in Jesus. When we walk with the Lord in the light of his will, what a glory he shares on our way. Trust and obey. There is no other way to be happy in Jesus but to trust and obey. You see, I'm walking with him. I'm trusting him. That is the enlightenment that Jesus is talking about. Glory to God. I'm walking with him. I'm trusting in him. See, it is the koinonia, the sharing with the Holy Spirit, listening to what the Holy Spirit is saying to me. Glory to God. It's the fellowship with the Holy Spirit. As I have fellowship with the Holy Spirit, when I hear, I do. That is why when we cross over to the book of James, it says, do not just be hearers of the word. Be doers of the word. Glory to God. He says he will communicate with us. When we hear what he is saying, then we do. Hallelujah. We do because we have heard. So when he has said, we are now acting in his word. When we act in his word, the devil is in trouble. Glory to God. Because the devil can no longer claim that which comes from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. It is the evil that people do. I was talking to one of my managers. It was a night shift. She came to me discussing the topic of heaven and hell. You know, I said, I'm a good person, Lom. I give to charity and this and that. I asked the question, you are good compared to who? God's standard of judgment is Jesus Christ. It's a revelation of who Jesus Christ is. You are good compared to who? You see, when we trust in our goodness, you see, when people do to charity, you're giving this, you are giving that, that's when you start going to God, Lord, don't you say, I've done this, I've done that. How come you have not? It's no longer Christianity anymore. It's no longer faith anymore. It's no longer the blood of Jesus anymore. It's no longer the cross anymore. It is now you. So I asked you a question. You are good compared to who? That is why when Jesus in Matthew 7 says, take that, what did he say? Take the beam away from your eye so that you can see the smote, the log out of your eye so that you can see the speck in your brother's eye. Judge not, for you shall be judged. What Jesus was talking about, he was addressing the people that were doing. They had trusted so much in their doing. God was not saying people should not judge. No, he was saying you need to learn to lean on me, to lean, to trust in me. I'm the only one that can make you do from a place of rest. I'm the only one that can make you see the speck in your brother's eye. But when you have a log, because you are trusting in yourself, you are comparing yourself with somebody else. So I ask, you are good compared to who? If somebody had drug addicts parents, they grew up in an environment which was infested by sexual immorality, and you grew up in an environment which was good, you had good parents that sent you to good schools, that educated you, the chances are you will eventually be good. If they gave you good moral standards, you will be good, right? That those are the chances that you will come out good in society. But that one that had it bad, that one that had it evil, the chances are already things are working against them. That is why what we need is Jesus Christ, to put our trust in Jesus, a revelation of Jesus Christ. God sees us through Jesus Christ. What we do is from Jesus Christ, understanding who he is, being enlightened on who he is. When we are enlightened on who he is, we are now enlightened to his saving grace. Oh, glory to God. Listen to what he says. Right. The eyes of your heart having been enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling and what are the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. Where I'm going is verse 19. And what is the surpassing greatness of his power towards us who believe? What's this? Believing. So we do because we believe. But we have to know what is the greatness of his power. So that greatness of his power, as it is working in us, we are now doing. Because we believe. We believe. We have been enlightened. What's this? Who believe according to the operation of the might of his strength, verse 20, which he caused to operate in Christ, in raising him from the dead and setting him at his right hand in the heavenlies. What's this? It says he raised Christ from the dead, set him in heavenlies on the right hand. The Holy Spirit raised Christ from the dead. Let's go to Ephesians 2, 6 as we round up. Glory to God. Ephesians 2 from verse 5, where I was. Even when we were dead in offenses, made us alive together with Christ. Now, let's connect the two. See, that you might know what is the exceeding greatness of his power towards us who believe when he raised Christ from the dead. Now, verse 5 here, verse 6 here, and raised us up together with him. So the Holy Spirit, when he raised Jesus from the dead, he raised us up with him. Glory to God. So we have been raised with Christ. We now have eternal life. We are not doing to try and have eternal life. We have been raised with him. Now, the same Holy Spirit that raised Christ from the dead is the same Holy Spirit that is operating in our life. That is the Spirit of life. That is eternal life. That is the gift of the Holy Spirit. It is a gift that has been given to us, just as in the natural. What regulates life in these mortal bodies of flesh that we have is blood. What will regulate your life as a Christian? It is the Holy Spirit. When Jesus did the works, it was through the power of the Holy Spirit. What raised Christ from the dead? It was the Holy Spirit. What brings enlightenment and illumination to us as God's children? It is the Holy Spirit. Glory to God. Now, that Holy Spirit is the life on the inside of us. If the Spirit of him that raised Christ from the dead dwells inside of us, that Spirit that raised Christ from the dead is able to quicken our mortal bodies. So that Holy Spirit has raised us with Christ. So when the Holy Spirit raised Christ from the dead, we as the church of the living God, we came out with him. We came out with a new life. We are the new creation. Glory to God. We are not like the rich young ruler. He was trying to get eternal life through works. So that is not us. Revelation knowledge. Glory to God. We have been raised with Christ. We are not going to be raised with Christ. No. You see, when you need to read the word, study it, know it. First John 3:1 says, beloved, how great is the love that the Father has lavished upon us, that we should be called the children of God. We should be called the children of God. And as if we didn't get it, verse 2 continues, now are we the children of God. Now are we the children of God. If we are the children of God, God is not flesh. Glory to God. God is life. He is eternal life. So when Christ was raised from the dead, the very life that Christ had is the very life that we have. It's in our spirit. That is the word of God. The incorruptible word, it is inside of us. It lives on the inside of us. We are of God. Glory to God. So we have to denounce these religious works. We have to come from a place of fellowship with the Father. You know, when we lift up his holy name, when we declare who he is, when we walk with him, when we abide in him, when we dwell in his presence, when we hear what he's telling us to do, when we are acting out, even whatever we do, because some will start asking, so what if I cannot hear? Where you are, in the church where you are, learn to serve. Be a servant. Glory to God. Go, mop the floor. Wipe the floor. Do something. As you are doing the little that you are doing, don't do it for people. One day, the Lord told me this. I think it's about last year. And I've not taught this. You know, I'm still building you up, leading you to what I ought to be really teaching. He says, Lord, talk to my children. I've not obeyed and talked to you. He says, tell my children. He says, most of them, when they are giving, even their offerings, they are giving their tithe, they are giving to pay rent. They are paying rent, or they are paying, whether some pastors that earn, I'm not against that. You know, they are paying, it's like they are paying rent. He says, Lord, I'm big enough to pay my rent. Tell them to stop. That any person that gives, whether it's for the pastor to be paid or to pay rent, says, tell them to stop. right? Because I'm big enough to pay the rent. Yeah, it teaches them that this is all about worship. It's about doing as the Spirit leads you. It's about having a revelation of who He is. I've set many people free. See, you have to come to the revelation of why you do what you do. Right? Are you doing it from a place of eternal life, from a place of rest, or you're doing? Well, if we don't give, who's gonna pay rent? You know, we got to give so that you mean God is broke that you can't pay the church rent? No, glory to God. We have to have a revelation why you do what you do. Because if it is not from revelation, it's from reason and religion. There is no life in it. We as God's children, we are in a place called life. Glory to God. It's the Holy Spirit leading us. We are doing because of Jesus, because we love Him, because we are in Him. We abide in Him. We live in Him. Imagine if this is how many Christians live their life. Me, when I hear what God tells me to do, I do it. It might not come out the way God might want it to come out, but I'm bold when God asks me to do something. And I'm not going to be seeking second opinion. Once I hear what He has, imagine the God who runs the universe. If He spends time to talk to you, to tell you, do this, and you start debating, I don't debate. You are saying I should do this. Okay, Lord, I will obey and do. See, this is how you do it. Glory to God. You make yourself available to God. Hallelujah. You yield to Him. You invite Him. Lord, what do you want me to do? When you are placed even in a church where He has placed you to be, you invite the Spirit of God. What do you want me to do? Do you want me to intercede? What do you want me to do? You know, as you begin to invite God in, guess what? He sees somebody He can use. He sees somebody who can do from a place of revelation. He sends somebody that He can promote. Oh, there is somebody I can promote. There is my David there who will do what I am asking him to do. There is my Mary who will do because they have sat at my feet. There is my Peter who will follow me. Glory to God. You see, most of the things that we're doing in the house of God, it's from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. We are doing good, 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 good. Remember what Jesus Christ said. Many will come to me. Says, Lord, we prophesied in your name. We cast out demons in your name. What did He say? I'll say, I never knew you. Because it did not come from life. Glory to God. It did not flow from life, from the tree of life. A Christian is in that place called life. He has crossed over from death to life. Jesus said to Martha, you know, before He raised Lazarus, says, I'm the resurrection and the life. Whosoever believes in me shall not die. He was talking about the Christian after the cross, the resurrection, because we have been raised with Him. He has raised us up together with Him and seated us together with Him in heavenly places in Christ. We are seated in heavenly places in Christ. The church is our business. It's not a pastor's business. It's not a prophet's business. It's our business. We are the church. Glory to God. We are the ones that have been called. We are the ecclesia. We are the government of God here on earth. He trusts us to do works because we are seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Listen, I wanted to get to verse 10, but not today. Li kam skele brokoto la kahai. Li kam skele brokoshanda. Li kam skele brokoto lo koyanda la kayende. Li kam skele brokoto la kahanda. In Jesus' mighty name. No, I will get to that. Listen, Ephesians 2:10, it says, you are a masterpiece. Right? We are a masterpiece. You see, being a masterpiece is because we are in Christ. Christ is the masterpiece. We were created in Him, just as Eve was taken out of Adam. What did Adam say? Wow, child. Flesh of my flesh, bone of my bones. We were taken out of Christ. We came out from Christ. So God is saying, you are a masterpiece. What's this? Created in Christ Jesus. Created in Christ. That is what a church is. That is what a Christian is. Anything outside this is not Christianity, it's dead religion. Come out of it. Created. I am not God. Take note to the tenses. Created. Not will be created when Christ comes. We are created in Him. Already it's a done deal. Glory to God. But we need revelation of what it means to walk in it. Created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God ordained for us to do before the foundation of this world. There are things that God called each and every one of us to do before the foundation of this world. Before I got here, God has called me to do something. But when I come to the revelation, number one, which is very, very important, I'm a masterpiece. He spoke this to me during handoff. I'm handing over. He says, "Lom, the key to good works is understanding who you are. When you understand that you are a masterpiece, when you know God calls you a masterpiece, when you start doing things, you won't be doing it looking for the praise of people. You won't be doing it looking for people's opinions. You will be doing it because you know who God is. So whoever approves of you, whoever disapproves of you, it will not move you. Glory to God. Because you know in his sight you are a masterpiece. Hallelujah. You know that you are created in Christ Jesus unto good works. So you are doing because you are a masterpiece. You are in Christ Jesus, created in him. You see, now that I am in him, I am flowing from that creation in him. I'm not trying to do so that he can endorse. No, I'm doing because I know who I am. I'm called to raise warriors. So I raise warriors. Glory to God. So you have to come to the revelation. What have you been called to do in the body of Christ? And be bold with it. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." He said, Jesus trusted in what the Father said concerning him. He knew who he was. The voice came from heaven, "Thou art my beloved son, in whom I'm well pleased." He said, we are seeking approval from men. Well, if I do this and if they don't approve, then you end up not doing, because the voice that is speaking is the voice of the enemy. Right? You are a masterpiece. You need to know, spend time meditating on you being a masterpiece. As you spend time meditating on you being a masterpiece, move to number two. You are created in Christ Jesus. As you meditate on you being created in Christ Jesus, you move to number three, unto good works. Unto good works, which he called you to do. There are things that only you can do, that Pastor Long cannot do. But you have to know, it has to come from a place of revelation. Not trying to do to please God. No. God is pleased with you. He was pleased with you before you got here. He created you. He loved you while you were still a sinner. How about now, when you spend time watching Zoom? You were sitting at home. You could be doing something. Even on Facebook, you could be doing something. Hallelujah. You see, it's because you love God. Hallelujah. Come to that revelation. God loves you. In the name of Jesus, I speak a blessing upon your life. You are blessed. Revelation. Let it flow freely. Unhindered by any demonic forces. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord strengthen you. May the Lord do you good. May you be delivered from a performance-based mindset to a grace-based mindset. Glory to God. Do from a place of grace. By grace you have been saved. You know, through faith, not of good works, that any should boast. It was his work. Glory to God. That as you begin to do, it's because you love Jesus. Likom skelebraka. As you go to your churches to save because of Jesus. Likam skelebraka. Limbrokotolo kayende lekebraka. Father, I've preached what you asked me to preach. Now, Father, I pray for the Holy Spirit. Let there be a manifestation of your word. Let it produce unlimited fold in Jesus' mighty name. Till we meet again, glory to God, in Jesus' name, amen.